Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulillah. Today we will talk about, my dear brother, the right of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make a sign of his mahabba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make a sign and proof of his love. Allah say, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, O Muhammad, if you pretend to love Allah, follow me. So the proof that you love Allah is that you must follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joined the iman on him with the iman of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whenever the name of Allah is mentioned, the name of his beloved Rasul is mentioned. And that's why, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept the iman on him if we don't believe in Muhammad. And this is the shahadatain. That's why we call shahadatain. Shahadatain, it means the two witnesses. To witness that Allah is the creator, but to join it to witness that Muhammad is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you say ashadu an la ilaha illallah, but you don't believe in Muhammad, your iman is rejected. You are not Muslim. This is the maqam of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you refuse the risala, as if you refuse the mursil. If you refuse the risala, if you refuse the messenger, as if you refuse the one who sent. And that's why Allah said in the Quran, كَدَّبَتْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. The people of Nuh reject the message of all the messengers. How come? And only Nuh has been sent to them. Because when you reject the message, as if you reject the message of all the anbiya. So the maqam of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear brother, first of all, is to believe in him. Our duty towards our Nabi is to believe. What does it mean, believe? If I believe that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, what does it mean? I believe also on what he says to me. If I heard a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as long as the hadith is authentic sources, yani the hadith is not lie. Whatever Rasulullah say, I have to admit and accept. I should not have in heart any doubt or reject the orders. Allah says in the Quran, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. By your Lord, O Muhammad, they will not have the iman حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ is the fight and arguments and cases, issues that happen between the people. Any issue they have, they have to submit to your decision. Now, after you submit to the decision of Rasulullah, ثُمَّ لَا يَجْدُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَلَيْتْ. And they should not, after submitting to what you said, anything in their heart. Sometimes you accept the orders, but in your heart, you don't like it. Allah say three conditions. You should accept the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Rasul. You should, in your heart, be pleased, be happy. And the third condition, وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Submit completely to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decide. So this is, my dear brother, the sign of iman on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are, my dear brother, the duty of us to believe in Muhammad, to love him more than your money. Because if you are asked to spend, you put your money beforehand. Love him more than your father and mother and brother and kids and even your nafs. You are ordered to defend him, to die before him, to have the ta'zim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Malik, as I said before, one man, he was raising his voice in the Masjid Nabawi. He told him the hurma of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hurma is the respect of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his deathbed, in his grave, like the hurma when he is alive. You cannot raise your voice, you cannot shout, and you cannot talk loud in the Masjid Nabawi. So my dear brother, respect him, defend him, love him, obey him, respect his hadith. If the hadith of Rasulullah is mentioned, everybody should quiet. You don't involve in anything. Sahl ibn Sa'd al-Sa'idi, a great Sahabi, he went to his hometown and he started reading to them the hadith. While he said one hadith, a man talked to another brother and they start laughing. They whispered to each other while he said the hadith. And they start laughing. He says to them, I am mentioning the hadith of Rasulullah and you talk to each other. By Allah, I will not live with you anymore. So he packed his horse and he was leaving. He says, where you are going? He said, I will go in the path of Allah to die and not live with the people that disrespect the hadith of Rasulullah. So my dear brothers, today, because time is short, I cannot mention all the issue of the duty towards Rasulullah. But today we'll talk about the mahabba, how Sahaba used to love Rasulullah. The Sahaba, the companion radiallahu anhu, my dear brothers, they give the best example. And Allah, as He said in the Quran, as He was pleased with them, they are the selection of Allah. Sahaba radiallahu anhu, my dear brother, you have to believe this. They are the selection. Allah selected them from all these ummah. No one till Qiyamah. We have to clear this in our mind, my dear brothers. Shaitan is smart. He put things in the heart. You have to understand that nobody will reach the level of one Sahabi if he do the a'mal of I don't know how much he do. He cannot reach the maqam of one Sahabi. Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, when he was asked, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, khair or you? Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, he make too much things to Islam. Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, they put him as the fifth Khalifa. And in his time, when people take out the money of Zakat, there was no one to give him the money. Aghna al-Nas, he make everybody satisfied. So, he says, by Allah, the dust, actually Abdullah ibn Mubarak, he was asked, sorry, who's better, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, radiallahu anhu, the Sahabi, or Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz? He says, by Allah, the dust in the forehead of Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, in one mashhad, it means in one going in the path of Allah, behind Rasulullah, is better than Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz and Ali Umar ibn al-Aziz, all his family. Why? Because the mashhad with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear brothers, is accepted by Allah. Allah select these people. So my dear brothers, today we'll talk short about Sahaba, how they used to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The love, my dear brother. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said to Rasulullah, when the number reached 39, and many people they said, Islam of Umar is because of sacrifice of Abu Bakr and the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why when they said, are you better or Abu Bakr, he cried. And Umar ibn Khattab said, one day of Abu Bakr will not be equal to all my amal and my family. So Abu Bakr said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, for how long we keep hiding our Islam? Let's talk openly in Mecca. And they were only 39. And Quraysh that time, they have the chief and the world making Hajj and Umrah, and they worship idols. So Rasulullah said to Abu Bakr Siddiq, we are few. He said, O Prophet of Allah, let's come out and I will speak. So they came to Haram, and Rasulullah was sitting, and Abu Bakr stand and he talk, and he start praise Allah, make salah Rasul, and read the Quran. So all the mushrikeen, they left all the Sahaba, and they come to Abu Bakr Siddiq. And Utba stand up on the chest of Abu Bakr, and he start hitting him with his shoes on the face, till he become red. Banu Taym, the tribe of Abu Bakr, when they pick him up, he says it looked like a red flag by the blood. All his body turned red. If he has clothes that are different color, it turned blood by the red by the blood. So whenever they touch him in any place, it moves. It means the head was completely injured. He has cut an injury in the whole head that when you touch anything, it moves. So when they take him to his mother, and she starts fix him, and he do medicine for him, he wake up almost sunset. He was fainted. He wake up almost sunset. The first word he said when he wake up, "Ma fa'ala Rasulillah, ma fu'ila bi Rasulillah." He says, "What happened to Rasulullah?" Now he forget his pain, because when he was hit, he did not know what happened to Rasulullah when he was beside him. So when he wake up before sunset, he said, "Ma fu'ila bi Rasulillah." Look this love. He forgets his pain. So his mother tell him, I don't know what happened to Rasulullah. So he told her, go to Ummu Jamil. Ummu Jamil, her name is Fatima, the sister of Umar. So she went to her, and she came to Abu Bakr, and she cried when she saw him. And he told her the same thing. What happened to Rasulullah? So they told him, eat first. He says, by Allah, I'm not going to eat and drink till I will see what happened to Rasulullah. So they took him, leaning on his shoulder, till they reached to Bab al-Arqam, and Rasulullah was okay. As soon as he saw him, Rasulullah started crying, and Sahaba cried because of his situation. So he told him, Allah, I don't have any pain except the injury in my head. And then he was happy, he was talking. Another time, my dear brothers, Rasulullah is when Abu Bakr Siddiq, when Rasulullah gave permission to Sahaba to go to immigrate, Abu Bakr Siddiq wants to immigrate. So he used to tell him, wait, maybe Allah will select for you a companion all the time. Aisha radiallahu anhu reported the story. She said, one day Rasulullah came to us in a time that he used not to come in that time. So when he came, he sat and he said to him, keep your wife and children away. He says, oh, Prophet of Allah, they are all Muslim. There is nothing to hide from him. So he tells them, oh Abu Bakr Siddiq, Allah order me that you will be my companion to immigrate to Medina. Khadija Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, I used to hear that a person cry by the happiness. يعني بكى من الفرح. By the joy he cried. But I never seen anyone who cried by the joy until I saw Abu Bakr Siddiq in that moment when he heard that Allah selected him to be the companion of Rasulullah, he cried by the joy. And when he went to the cave, he told him, oh Rasulullah, wait, so if I will go and clean the cave, so if there is any scorpions or snake, it will bite you, it will bite me, it will not touch you. And when he was on the way to the immigration, he was going forward, and after a while he was going behind. Rasulullah told him, oh Abu Bakr Siddiq, ma balik, what happened to you? He says, ya Rasulullah, adhkuru rasda, fa'akunu amamak, hatta amuta dunak, wa adhkuru annahum yatba'unak, fa'aji wara'ak, hatta amuta dunak. He says, oh Abu Bakr, oh Prophet of Allah, I think that they may be waiting for you on the way. So I come forward to fight so I can die before they touch you. And I remember that maybe they are following us. So I come behind you, so I can die before that they touch you. This is a sign of love, my dear brothers. Another example, my dear brothers. In the battlefield of Hunayn. Battlefield of Hunayn, Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam, the mushrikeen, يعني they come and they kill a lot of huffat, and the sahaba scattered. Rasulullah stayed alone, and the mushrikeen surrounded him. Talha radiallahu anhu, when he saw the arrow, when the people of the arrow target Rasulullah, almost 100 arrow coming. Talha hugged Rasulullah. He hugged him. He put him on his chest and grabbed him. And almost 70 arrows come in his body. 70 arrows. And that's why, my dear brother, Rasulullah, when he did the first khutbah of Jumu'ah after the battlefield of Uhud, he saw Talha coming. And he was having green qamis, all bleeding. So he says in the Quran, من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر. He says some people that they are trustworthy, they fulfill the promise of Allah. Some of them passed away, and some of them still alive. And when he reached to some of them still alive, he pointed his finger in the majma' towards Talha. And he says, وَهَذَا مِمَّنْ يَنْتَدِرْ. It means he is shaheed. And Rasulullah said in another hadith, whosoever wants to see a martyr that is walking on the ground, he should look to Talha radiallahu anhu. Ummu Umara, a woman, because the news spread, Rasulullah died. So Ummu Umara, she came, radiallahu anha, and her name is Nasiba, from the Ansar, and she put a mask on her face, and she starts fighting in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Till Rasulullah knew her, he said, Ummu Umara, she said, yes, أبرز الله. And she got her almost 11 wounds. يقول الرسول ما التفت يمينا ولا شمالا إلا نظرت إلى عمارة تدافع دوني. Whenever I took right or left, I saw عمارة fighting front of me. سعد بن الربيع. I'm giving you an example of this Sahaba, how they used to love Rasulullah. Sa'd ibn Rabi', when he died in the battlefield of Uhud, Rasulullah sent him Zayd ibn Thabit. He says, give salam to Talha, to Sa'd ibn Rabi', and ask him how he feel. So he says, I start look to him among the dead, and I find him, bihi ramaq. It means he is in his last breath. So I tell him, oh Sa'd, Rasulullah is giving you salam and tell you, how do you feel? He told him, I smell the smell of Jannah. And then he tell him, tell to the Ansar. Listen to this. He says, قل للأنصار ليس لكم عذر عند الله إن خلص إلى رسول الله وفيكم عين تطرف. He says, you will have no excuse front of Allah. This is his wasiyah. Amazing. One of the best will. One of the best will that any sahab, any Muslim can make in the history of Islam. This is his will. He says, tell to the Ansar, you will have no excuse before Allah if anyone reach to Rasulullah by small inch and touch him, and you have one eye that blink. It means, even if you are completely dying, you have a little bit effort, you cannot let anything touch Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khubayb ibn Idi, radiallahu anhu. The mushrikeen touch him. He was from the people who joined the battlefield of Badr, and he killed some mushrikeen of the Mecca. So they catch him. And when they put him on the hill outside the haram, and they ask the people who sent sharp in the shooting the arrow, shoot him on the side of his body. So they shoot him on the side of his body, till his flesh was completely open from the side because of the arrows. Then the Abu Sufyan told him, that time he was not Muslim, قَالَ يَا خُبَيْبُ أَتُحِبُّ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا مَكَانَكَ وَأَنْتَ فِي أَهْلِكَ وَمَالِكَ. Do you love that Muhammad will be in your place? Hang, then we will kill him. And you are sitting with your wife and children. قَالَ وَاللَّهِ مَا أُحِبُّ أَنِّي بَيْنَ أَهْلِي وَمَالِي وَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ يُشَاكُ بِشَوْكَ. By Allah, I don't want to be with my wife and children, and Rasulullah will have a thorn that will enter in his feet. It means, if I knew that the thorn will be on that way, I would wish to put my feet, then Rasulullah step on my feet, and the thorn would go inside. This is the love of Sahaba radiallahu anhum. My dear brothers, the ulama they said radiallahu anhum, Sahaba, not only they love with emotions, like now, people make demonstration. Why you shout to Rasulullah, and you find the person does not even pray. You find the person does not even pay zakat, does not even fast Ramadan. He doesn't even have one sunnah from his life. This deen is not emotions. The deen is not emotion. And I don't mean that you don't demonstrate when people talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But I mean that this deen is a life. You have to, if you love Rasulullah, you have to bring his ways. You have to listen to him. If you hear the hadith of Rasulullah and you prefer the ways of the non-believers over his way, which kind of love you are talking about? Which kind of love? Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. And that's why Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and in another riwayah, Abdullah ibn Hudafa, he was coming to the masjid. Rasulullah in the minbar said, sit down. He was talking to the people in the masjid. Jlisu. He said, Jlisu. He heard Jlisu. It was the time of Duhr. Very hot and the sand. He sat down on the heat and he did not move. The majlis finishes and Sahaba left the masjid. When they left, they find him sitting all sweating in the heat. So they tell him, what you are doing? He says, I heard Rasulullah tell me, sit, and I sat. Did you see the obedience? The obedience, complete submission. Allah in the Quran sent the hukm. Because, my dear brother, whenever the verse of the order of Allah come, Sahaba used to walk on the street, repeat the verse. And they bring the translation to their family. Everybody practice, same day, no delay. So Allah says in the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ وَتُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Anything that you hide, good or bad, I will bring it openly in front of you in Qiyamah. And if it's bad and I want to punish you, I will punish you. And if I will to forgive you, I will forgive you. So Sahaba come, look the Iman. قال يا رسول الله كلفنا الصيام والصلاة والجهاد فأطقناها. وهذه الآية لا نطقها. We cannot practice this ayah. Look my dear brothers, we read from Surah Al-Nas till from Al-Baqarah till Al-Nas, and some people they have no order of Allah. This Sahaba, one order came in the Quran. They said, O Prophet of Allah, we can do everything, all the a'mal, except this ayah we cannot. It means you hide something bad. For example, you think to do haram, you think to lie. It's in your chest, it's in your heart. You did not did it yet. Allah will take hisab and punish you or forgive you. So this is very difficult. So they said to Rasulullah, we cannot do that. Rasulullah got extremely angry. He says, أتريدون أن تقول كما قالت يهود والنصارى سمعنا وعصينا بل قولوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. He says, say, listen, we listen and we obey. Oh Allah, forgive us. يقول الراوي فقرأ القوم حتى ذلت بها ألسنتهم. It means they keep saying سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا إليك المصير everywhere they are, even in their bed. Then Allah was so pleased with them and Ibrahim, the ayah of the Quran. First he praised them. وَقَالُوا قَالُوا in plural. It means they said. Who they said? Sahaba. Allah praised the Sahaba in the Quran in many verses. وَقَالُوا سَمِينَ وَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا عَلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. So my dear brothers, the Sahaba, they have the love. They have the ittiba. They submit. They have the ta'zim. Ta'zim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Bara ibn Azim says, I had a question in my heart. And I want to ask Rasulullah. For 2 years I don't ask him because of the haybah. Abdul Amr ibn al-As in the deathbed, he says, when I accept Islam, I never look to Rasulullah to his face. And if someone asks me, how describe to me Rasulullah, I cannot tell him how Rasulullah look like. Because I never look to his face. Allahu Akbar. From the time he accepted Islam. Look this ta'zim. Ta'zim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also my dear brothers, the Sahaba, they are ready to sacrifice the money and the dunya, but they cannot sacrifice Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Hunayn, all the non-believers, the Muslim who accept Islam and join the battlefield, they ran away from the battle because they were new in Islam. Rasulullah said to Al-Abbas, his uncle, call me Ashab al-Shajara, call me the Ansar, call for me the Ansar of Medina. So the Ansar, they surround Rasulullah, and they were almost 80 persons. And Allah bring the help, and they overpower, and they win the battlefield. When the booty come of Hunayn, these 80 people, 100 people from the Ansar, Rasulullah, they give them nothing. And he gave to those new accepted Islam, 100 camel, 50 sheep, etc. Lot of booties. So when he returned, Sa'd ibn Ubada, radiallahu anhu, came to Rasulullah. And he says, O Prophet of Allah, the Ansar, they were sad with your division. And they are the one who, they said, when the hard time come, we are cold. And when the booty come, we don't get anything. They are human beings, they are not prophet. This is coming in their heart. So Rasulullah said to Sa'd, why did you not answer them? He says, Ya Rasulullah, ana min al-qawm, I am from the people. I cannot talk to them. So he says, gather them for me in the gathering of camels. You know the place of camel? The place of camel is not clean. He says, gather them for me there. Why? Because now the talk is the talk of dunya. Look how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hikmah, the wisdom that Allah put in the heart of Rasulullah. He doesn't want to talk about this issue in masjid. He gathered them in Hadirat al-Ibil. So when they are gathered, he says to them, Ya ma'ashara al-ansar, alam atikum kuffaran, fahadakum Allahu bi, a'da'an, fa'allafa Allahu baynakum bi, ya'ani fuqara, fa'aghnakum Allahu bi. He says, O group of ansar, I came to you, no believers, and Allah give you hidayah because of me. And enemies, and Allah join your heart because of me. And poor, and Allah make you rich, ghani, because of me. For they said, Bala ya Rasulullah, yes, O Prophet of Allah, you are right. He says, Ajibu, answer me. They said, Al-mannu lillahi wa rasulih. Look at the knowledge of Ansar, Allahu Akbar. Al-man, when somebody tells to you, he is favor over you. I did to you this. And the Ansar, they did too much. This Hunayn is almost in the year 8. They did years of sacrifice. 2 years before the death of Rasulullah. But still they said, Al-mannu lillahi wa rasulih. Well, I'm not going to say our favors to you. No. Only Allah and His Rasul can say their favors to us. So he says, if you said, I will tell you are right, and Allah on His arsh, He will tell you are right. جئتنا طريدا فأويناك فقيرا فأغنيناك مخدولا فنصرناك. You came to us, kicked out, and we give you refuge. People cheated you, and we give you help. And you come alone and poor, and we give you all our means. So he says, answer. They said, Al-mannu lillahi wa rasulih. We are not going to see our favors. So he says, why you are angry about du'a? Du'a, my dear brothers, is when you finish the cup from water or anything, and that drop is left. That's called du'a. He says, did you get angry for some leftovers of this dunya? I give it to some people that are newly in Islam to make them closer to the deen. Don't you like that people will carry camels and sheep on their shoulder, and you carry Rasulullah between you? He says, by Allah, if the whole people in the world take one way and the Ansar take another way, I will take the way of Ansar. And without the, if there is no hijrah, I will be man from the Ansar. An-nasu ditar wal ansaru shi'ar. Ditar is the clothes that we wear outside. Ditar is the clothes that we wear close to the flesh, underwears, the upper underwear. Rasulullah said, An-nasu shi'ar wal ansaru ditar. Allahumma gfir lil ansar wa li abna'i al ansar wa li abna'i abna'i al ansar. So all of them cried, and they said, listen to their answer, the final answer. The Ansar, they said, Radina billahi rabban wa bi rasulillahi qasaman. We are happy with Allah as Lord and Muhammad as a share. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a share. It means we got nothing from the dunya, but the share that Rasulullah is with us, this is the best share. So Rasulullah tells them at the end, Isbiru, satajidu ba'di athar, fasbiru hatta taridu alayya al-hawm. You will be in the future, people will not give you your rights. So be patient till you meet me in the river of Kawthar. So Sahaba, my dear brother, they used to love Rasulullah. They used to respect him. They used to follow him. And my dear brother, they misses him. Anas ibn Malik said, when we Rasulullah came to Medina, everything light, everything become bright. And as soon as we bury him, everything turned dark. Bilal refused to make the Adhan after Rasulullah died. Aba Ubaidah in the Sham, this is the first time he will call Adhan, they ask Abu Ubaidah to order him to give Adhan. When he reached to Ashhadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah, he cried and he fainted. He could not finish it. In the dead bed, his wife said, Wa Bilalah, oh my Bilal, what will happen to you? And she cried. He says, Barquli wa farhatah. Al-yawma alqa al-ahibba Muhammadan wa sahbah. Today I'm going to meet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Sahaba, my dear brothers, they used to love Rasulullah. In our time, my dear brothers, love is not emotion. Love is not only demonstrations. Love is that you see his ways. What Rasulullah tell you? You do it. You can't do it. You say, oh Allah, I am weak. Give me tawfiq to do it. This is the love. The love is the ittiba. If you love someone and you disobey him, your love is only pretend, is a lie. تَعْسِلْ إِلَهَا وَأَنْتَ تُدِيرُ حُبَّهُ هَذَا الْعَمْرِ فِي الْقِيَاسِ بَدِيعُ لَوْ كُنْتَ تُعْلِنُ حُبَّهُ لَأَطَعْتَهُ إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَا يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. السلام عليكم.